how to hang this Founders Day banner. How's Governor Groundhog and his grandparents look now?
Happy, because it's our town's birthday. How's our quilt look?
Everyone's patches look perfect. The governor's gonna love it.
It's a fine Founders Day gift if ever I saw one, Sheriff.
And just think, if Jedediah and Mariah Groundhog hadn't started this town, we wouldn't be living in it.
Reckon I better add my patch. The governor will be here soon to celebrate.
Keep a stitching, everyone. We need our patches in place before he gets here.
The governor's coming on the 12:30 train. Folks are so excited across the prairie and the plain. We're wishing happy birthday to our nice and friendly town. Yippee-yi, Cali-ki-yay, it's the Founders Day hoedown.
Yee-haw, yee-haw, we're gonna cheer and celebrate. The folks who made our town so great. We're gonna give a
dig up gold.
And my patch is a milkshake always served up nice and cold.
And since I'm such a lady, I sewed a pretty rose.
And since I'm far mistakey, mine's a clothespin for your nose.
Peck, aren't you gonna add a patch to the town quilt?
There's room right here between Mr. Dillo's hammer and Teal's lucky hat.
It's a dandy looking blanket, everyone, but I'm working on something special to give the governor. Sorry, don't want to ruin the surprise.
Okay, but remember to meet us at the governor's train at 12:30 sharp.
I'll be there on account of having a deputy with a just you wait and see governor gift. How's that look, Clementine?
Yeehaw.
Well, if I missed a spot, raise me up and I'll fix her. It's gotta be perfect. I know my friends mean well, but a simple quilt doesn't seem special enough to get the governor on Founders Day. There! Done! And boy, is it special!
He thinks his gift is special.
That's the governor's train. Clementine, loan me down quick.
Sheriff, it's nearly 12:30. Must be the governor's train.
Okay, everybody, grab a corner of the quilt and let's get our gift to the station.
Put more Clippity in your club, Clementine. We gotta be there when they give the governor the quilt. After which, we'll dazzle them with our gift. You're right. If the governor thinks the quilt is too simple a gift for Founders Day, he might get back on the train and never see my big surprise.
All
All right, our big surprise. Only one thing to do, Clementine. Show the governor our gift first, on account of we want to do our town proud. Stop in the name of the law!
What's going on, deputy?
We've reached nice and friendly corners already. Good folks of nice and friendly corners, I'm proud to see you.
Pardon me, Governor, but slight change of plans. Hop on! I wonder what's keeping the governor's train.
Yeah, my waiting muscles are wondering the same thing.
Here it comes, everybody! Hold up the quilt nice and high so the governor can see it! Welcome, Governor Groundhog!
What in whiskers?
Where is he?
This just in. Governor's train arrives, but he's not on it. A question everyone's asking, why?
Deputy Peg, this sightseeing tour is, unexpected pleasure, but, when are we getting to, wherever we're going?
Right around that bend, Governor. And on account of this Founder's Day surprise being so special and all, I'm gonna blindfold you to make it extra surprising. Governor Groundhog, happy Founder's Day!
My, what a lovely log.
Oh, sorry, Governor. Your surprise is this away.
It's magnificent. A monumental testament in stone to my beloved ancestors, Mariah and Jebediah Groundhog, who founded Nice and Friendly Corners. And I don't look so bad myself. Well done, Deputy Pet. Oh, and of course you too, Clementine.
Would you like to pose with it and I'll take your picture?
Grand idea, Deputy, grand idea.
Deputy Peck stopped the train?
That's right, Sheriff. Then he led the governor towards Rocky Ridge.
Rocky Ridge? Why would he take him to those Badlands? I better go see what he's up to. I'll be back soon, folks, with Peck and the governor. Giddy up, Sparky!
Say yee-haw!
Yee-haw!
Looks like there's one itty-bitty hair out of place.
Well, it is a bit windy up here.
Not your hair, Governor. An itty-bitty stone hair. But I'll have it fixed in a jiffy. Perfect! Perfect horsey toes! Rocky Ridge is crumbling out from under us! Now, Governor, no need to panic. I know just what to do.
Get you both off these rocks before someone gets hurt. I'll have to find another way to get you down.
I'm sorry, Sheriff. None of this would have happened if I hadn't tried to unspecial the quilt.
The quilt? That's it? Hold tight, fellas. I'll be back faster than lightning across the prairie. Let's go, Sparky.
Maybe we shouldn't put away our quilt just yet. The governor might still show up.
Well, I'm afraid he left us with nothing but tomorrow's headline, Toby. Governor throws wet blanket on town's big blanket.
Everybody, Peck and the governor are stranded on Rocky Ridge. But I know how to save them. Gather up the quilt and follow me.
Situation, I must say, the view from up here is
scary!
Don't worry, Governor! Sheriff Callie's here with help!
Okay, everybody, spread out the quilt right here and hold her nice and tight!
Sheriff, is this really the best time to show the governor the quilt?
But it is a good time for you two to jump! Jump!
Well, I don't know about this.
We'll catch you! Come on!
I wish to thank all you noble citizens of nice and friendly corners for your spectacular rescue. And for the spectacularly special quilt, every patch will make me think of you fine folks. Thank you on behalf of the entire Groundhog family.
Reckon I had to fall into this quilt to see what a jim-dandy gift it really is.
We know you meant well, Peck, but sometimes simple gifts are the most special.
Just wish I'd seen fit to help y'all make it.
It's not too late. There's still a spot to add a patch.
And I've got just the right one.
Here you go, Peck. A pinned in place prickle.
Now it's even more special.
It's simply really special. Winterby turns pretty.
Old Nicky, on account of all my deputies made her a tense dusty. Night, Peck.
We need buckets, Uncle Bun. Lots and lots of buckets.
'Cause me and my little brother got a whole lot of shoveling to get done.
Here you go.
Good news, fellas. You boys find gold?
Not yet, but I reckon we will soon.
We got us a newfangled gold-finding contraption.
Called a sluice. Putting it together was a grimy, gritty job.
And we loved every dirty minute of it.
Looks like you brought along half your mine with you.
And we best get back to it. Come on, big brother. There's dirt to be dug.
Nothing I like better than getting muddy with my little brother, Buddy.
Never seen brother. brothers with a better get-along.
Because they love playing in the dirt.
Go, little brother. A nice bucket of dirt to pour into our brand new mining contraption.
Looks like half of it wound up in my boot instead, big brother.
So it did, and yours kind of missed the mark, too.
I could play in the dirt all day, Dusty, but I reckon some of it ought to go into our new sluice. Already caught a nugget.
Already? Alrighty.
Can't quite reach it.
Careful, little. Dan, you're clean. Is he gonna be all right, Doc?
All right? He's better than ever. Shinier, too.
But why are his clothes all... Why?
Don't you remember, Dusty? They were white when I first bought them.
Oh, yeah. Well, I reckon we better get to dirty-izing them right quick, little brother.
Now, that is a mighty fine idea, big brother. So that's what clean sounds like.
Please, brother, folks might see you looking all... Ooh.
Howdy, Dusty.
Howdy, stranger. Welcome to town.
Stranger? Hey, it's me, Dirty Dan.
Dirty Dan? Holy jalapenos! Where'd you get the fancy new clothes?
All these old things? I had them for years. The squeak's new, though.
Come on, little brother. The dirt's this way.
Oh, my. Ooh-hoo. Clumsy me. I dropped my lovely lace hanky. You'd think some clean and handsome gentleman would pick it up.
Me? You think I'm handsome?
Oh, don't worry, brother. You won't be for long.
Leaping lassos, don't you clean up nice. Keep it up and folks will start calling you Clean Dan.
Clean Dan? Wait! Hear that, Dusty? I got me a dandy new nickname.
Why, this is fake news. I can see the headline. Dirty turns party.
I'm going to be in the newspaper?
I want the whole story. Nice and Friendly Corners needs to know.
And I'll go get my camera. They need to see you, too.
Wait, there we go. Dirty Dan.
Smile, Queen Dan.
Better start digging without me, brother. I might be a spell.
Oh, what's keeping Dirty Dan? Figured he'd have smelled the slop soup by now and come a-running.
Dusty, looky, looky! My picture's on the front page!
Folks do make a fuss over the silliest things. Now pull up a rock and have some nice hot slop.
Ooh, it does smell tasty. but it's maybe a mite too messy.
A little messy never bothered you before, Dirty Dan.
It's clean, Dan, now.
Well, not for long. Once we get back to digging and a-dumping, you'll feel a whole hog better.
I can't.
What?
Well, I kind of like being clean and how it feels to have folks pay attention to me. Not to mention how it feels to walk without dirt in my underpants.
What are you saying?
I reckon my digging days are over. Least while I still got a squeak in my step. But we can still have fun together. Priscilla's invited me to a tea party, and her little cookies are right yummy. If and you gobble down enough of them, clean up and come.
Clean up? No, thank you.
Well, then I best get moseying on.
Who is this stranger neath my brother's hat? Oh, Dirty Dan, why'd you have to turn clean on me? What can you do when your brother don't clean? Spends all his time with a washing machine. It's like he's forgotten the fun times we had. Cleaning dirt always made us so glad. I remember and dumping and making mud pies. Life was so happy for us and our flies. But now it's just me all alone with my dirt since my brother's gone clean. I got nothing but picture of a little brother the way I like to remember him. Dirty. If only I could bring him back from his clean, loving ways. That's it. I just gotta get him dirty again. And I know how. A flying mud pie on his pretty white clothes. This'll make Dan remember all the filthy fun he's missing.
Allow me, ma'am.
Huh? Well, lucky thing I got plenty more dirty tricks up my sleeve. Or under my hat, anyway. That should do it, Mr. Dillo. Toby, want a milkshake?
You bet! Yum, yum, yum!
It's my automatic clean and dirtyizer. There he is now.
Let's go.
Now to add some dirt.
In whiskers? Almost.
There you go, Toby.
Yum.
Dusty, why in the Wild West are you dirtying up the whole town?
I didn't mean to, Sheriff. The only one I want to get dirty is Dan. I'm just trying to make him remember all our dirt digging fun.
Sounds like you really miss him.
Uh-huh. The sound of one shovel digging is just so lonely.
There's gotta be a better way to tell Dan what's on your mind, don't you think?
I surely do, Sheriff. But I'm gonna need a lot more tossing dirt.
Reckon I better help those brothers patch things up, and fast.
feeling lonely, cause land is not like dirt. Will they get back together before someone gets hurt?
I'm gonna get me so much dirt the next time I can't miss him.
Thanks for coming with me, Dan. Dusty's got a lot on his mind, and I'm hoping you two can talk.
Well, I'm a real good listener, now that I washed the dirt out of my ears. I'm a-coming, brother!
Giddy up, Sparky!
You gotta save my brother, Sheriff!
That's what I aim to do!
Are you okay?
I'm fine, other than a bruise or two. And you not wanting to be my brother anymore.
What's that talk? I'll always be your brother, Dusty.
You mean it? Or is that just the soap talking?
Of course I mean it. You're the best big brother ever.
And you're the best big old brother ever.
Fellas, I do believe Dusty's covered in gold dust.
Well, I'll be a mud-faced mole. You're scootin' to toot uncovered a gold mine, big brother.
And it's just begging to be dug up.
Wait up, big brother. I'll help.
You'll get real birdie.
There's a time to be clean and a time to be dirty. And this